Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to run Java program in VS Code. VS Code is one of the most popular IDE. I will be showing you how to download, how to use it, everything I'm going to show you. So watch my video till end. So guys, let's begin. So for running Java program, you require JDK as well as you require VS Code ID. So first of all, I will be showing you how to download VS Code. So now guys, for that, what I'm doing, I'm just starting my command prompt and I'm showing you that I'm not having any Java install on my PC. So you can see I have just typed Java hyphen hyphen version and it is showing me Java is not recognized. So guys, I don't have Java install on my PC. Now let me go to browser and let me show you how to install Java. So you can open any of your favorite browser and just type JDK download. And guys, here you can see the official website oracle.com. You have to click on Java download link. And guys, now here Java 20 is available and different operating system it is showing. So you have to click on Windows because I'm using Windows. So if you have any other operating system, you can just change that. So just select this Windows tab and just scroll down. And here we have different products available. I'm going to take x64 MSI installer and will click on this link. So guys, you can see my download has been started. It will not take time. You can see it's done. So now to start setup, I need to click on this MSI and here I'm going to click on next button. Guys, this is the installation location for Java. Just click on next button. So Java is successfully installed. Done guys, click on this close button. So we have one prerequisite, Java. Now we will be installing VS Code. Okay, so we have to set the path also, that I will be showing you later on, because I wanted to show you that if you don't set path, you will get error. Now guys, after starting command prompt, I'm just typing Java hyphen hyphen version. So you can see it's showing me version also. Okay, so this path is required for whenever you are using IDE and all that thing. So we will be setting. So again, start your web browser and then type VS Code download. Here is the official website. Click on this link. And guys, here we have different operating system. Based on that, you can download. I'm just clicking on this Windows. And guys, my download has been started and it is done. It hardly takes a time. So now let's click on this exe message. So I'm just going to click on OK on this message. Here I'm going to click on I accept the agreement and then I'm going to click on this next button. I'm going to add what my VS Code in my menu, start menu. So that is okay. I'm going to click on next button. If you don't want, you can check mark that. And this is if you want to create shortcut on desktop, you can check. And the next option is that when you right click and if you want open with VS Code, you can check mark on this. So I'm doing that and next button. And guys, here we need to click on install button. So installation will be started. Here it is showing me ready to install. So whatever configuration we have selected, it will install on that basis. Click on install button. And guys, here the installation has been started. We will wait. Okay guys, my installation is done. Now it's showing me this screen. So I'm just want to launch this VS Code. So I will check this and I will click on finish button. So guys, my VS Code is started and this is a welcome screen for VS Code. Here it's showing different themes available. Whatever themes you want to select, you can select. Let me select a dark high contrast theme. Okay, so you can select any one of them, no problem. Let me close this welcome page. I don't need this welcome page. And now guys, now the important step we are going to follow, that is what extension. So for running Java program, you required few extension. Okay, in VS Code, if you want to run anything, any program, you need to download extension. So just go to this extension tab and guys, here you have to search for two extension. Okay, the first extension is Java. Just type Java, it will show you various options. Select this option, extension extension pack for Java. So this is going to install 6 extensions. Since it is a pack, it is going to install 6 extensions. So here are the 6 extensions. It will install what? Test runner, Maven, project manager, language support for Java, debugger, all the 6 packs it will install. So you can see I'm clicking on this install button and my installation has been started. It is showing me installing. Since it will install 6 packs, so it will take a while, so we will wait for it. Okay guys, so installation for Java package done. Here my Java development is ready. Now I will suggest you to install one more extension, and that is Code Runner. Okay, so let me close this, and you can see here it has installed all this for my Java, right? Language support, project, so total 6 has been installed. So now let's install another extension. So here type Code Runner. So you can see these are coming under install tab, right? Okay, so let me type Code Runner over here. Code Runner is one of the popular extension, so it can be used for any programming language. So Code Runner, you have to install this one, okay, .run. Okay, so this is the Code Runner. Just click on install button. So done, installation of Code Runner is done. So guys, now let me show you how to create project. So go to file menu and click on open folder over here, and you can browse your folder wherever you want to save your program. So I'm just taking my CS corner folder and I'm just clicking on this select folder. So just click on this select folder. So now guys, here it's showing me, do you trust the author of this folder? Yes, I trust. Just click on this button and you can see under my explorer it's showing me my folder CS corner, right? So now you can create your file inside this. Just click on this new file button and give your file name, Java file name. So guys, here you need to provide a Java file name. So I'm giving Java file name as hello demo.java, and hit enter guys, and you can see your Java file got created over here, right? Now we will be writing code. So let's start with a class. So here I'm writing public class, and guys, here you can see the option, select the second option, so automatically the line will be generated. So public class hello demo curly bracket is generated. Now next I will write psvm and then select this, and you can see guys, public static void main, which is nothing but entry point for Java program, is generated. Now I want to print simple statement, so I'm typing s out, and again you can see system.out.println is generated. In this I'm just going to print a simple message, thanks for watching. So guys, my code is done, my program is ready now. So I will run this program. So to run this program, you have to simply right click. You can right click anywhere and just select the option run code. Guys, here you can see I'm not getting my output because it's showing me Java C is not recognized as an internal or external command. So what do you need to do? You need to set the path in environmental variable. So now guys, let's set the path for Java. So for that, first of all, I will go to my folder, Java folder, and I'm going to copy the path of Java. So here in my C:\Program Files under Java, here I'm having JDK 20, and in that I'm having bin folder. So I'm going to copy this path. So just simply copy path till bin. Okay, now in search box type env and it will open what? Your edit the system environment variable. Click on this and here click on environmental variable button. So it will open this window, and now here under system variable you have to search for path variable. So here you can see we have a path variable. Just select the path variable and click on what? Edit button, right? Okay, so now here we will add the path which we have copied. So just click on new button and paste the copied path. So here new button and paste the copied path, and guys click on OK button. So this is done, path variable is done. We will be creating one more variable, java_home. So now for that click on this new button and type here java_home, and then paste the copied path, and you have to paste path until what? JDK, not a bin. Okay, so this is done. So after setting this path, I will go again to my VS Code and then I will run my program. So let me just right click again anywhere and I'm going to select run code, and boom guys, I'm getting my output. Thanks for watching. Okay, so this is done. I got my output. Now one more point I would like to show you, because if you are doing Java program, definitely you may require user input. So you can see the output is coming under this output tab, right? But we want output should come in a terminal tab, because for accepting user input, terminal is required. So now simply I'm just modifying my program and I'm creating one object of scanner so that I can accept input from user, and then I'm asking user that enter some value, and whatever value user is entering, I'm just storing that into a variable, and then guys I'm just trying to print that value. Okay, this is my simple Java code, and now what I'll do, I'll run this program. Okay, so if I'm running this program, you can see again the output is coming in this output tab, enter some value, but guys here I'm not able to type. Okay, I'm not able to type. So if you want to accept user input, this way will not work. So we have to just change the output should come into terminal. Okay, so now here at the left side there is a setting button. Just click on this, go to settings button, and guys here go to this last option, that is extension option, and here you have to go to what, run code configuration, right? And here you need to search for run in terminal. So just scroll down and you will get this option, run in terminal. Just check mark this. That's all guys, that's all done. So now close this setting and now go to your hellodemo.java, and then what you can do, you can again right click anywhere and select run code. So guys, my code is already running. I just stop it and I will run it again. So now here it's showing me output in my terminal tab and it is asking me enter some value. Okay, so I'm entering 39 and guys it is showing me value equal to 39. That means it is accepting my user input. So guys, I have shown you everything, like installation to how to accept user input in Java. I hope guys, by following my video, you are able to successfully run your Java program in VS Code. So guys, if my video has really helped you, don't forget to click on like button. And if you have any type of query, you can put in comment box. I will surely reply to your queries. And guys, I'm sharing lots of PDF and notes freely on my Telegram channel. The link of my all social media I have given in description box. You can follow me there also. And guys, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press bell icon to receive more videos from my channel. Thank you guys for watching my video till end. I'll see you in my next video. Till that, bye bye and take care.